So Bolt.new got a new feature, and it is the ability to create native mobile applications using Bolt. So if you see here, create native mobile apps with Bolt. Okay. And you can also see this button here, which says build a mobile app with Expo. So it's actually using Expo, and let's check out what Expo is. Let's go to expo.dev. Create universal native apps with React that run on Android, iOS, and the web. And see this? We are the home of developers building native apps across Android and iOS with JavaScript. We are open source. And there is a mobile app called ExpoGo that we can use to visualize our app, whether it is in Android or iOS. You can download this application in both Android and iOS. Okay, so let's go back to bolt.new, and I'm going to come here and click on this button. It says build a mobile app that dot dot dot, and I'm going to press shift enter one more time and then paste this prompt here. Okay, so the prompt is build an app that will convert a paragraph to English, but how it will sound in American English. Users should be able to add some auto paragraphs and also be able to paste custom paragraphs. For reference, I've given an example. So this is an English paragraph, and below that there is the American phonetic representation. So the same paragraph will be represented like this. So that's the prompt I'm giving, and I'm going to click on enter. I'll help you build a mobile app that converts English text to its American English phonetic representation. Okay, so building the mobile application. So we have preview on your own mobile device. So this is the process. Install ExpoGo app, whether you are using Android or iOS, and then you can just scan this QR code. This is one method. You can scan it on your phone, or you can visualize the app here using Pixel 9 or Galaxy 24. Okay, I'm just going to close this one, and this is how it looks. Let's set it to responsive. I'm actually going to copy this exact text from here, Control C, and I'm going to paste it here and convert. It gives us original text and the American phonetic text. Okay, so we have two icons. One is the convert icon, which is this. And then there is sample icon, which we have placeholder or default text that cannot be changed. Okay, so this is how it looks. Let's look at iPhone 16, and this is what we get. Let's look at Pixel 9. Okay, this is what it is. I think the app is fine. I'm just going to give this follow-up prompt, add authentication, and let's see if it can add that. I think it will connect to Supabase. So there are some errors. Let's attempt to fix it. Okay, so it's just the Supabase based issue. So I'm just going to connect here, click on that. It will open a new page. Okay, so I will select that, and I'll go to authorize Bolt. Okay, Supabase successfully connected. So connecting to Supabase, done. It has created a project, set up authentication, done. Create database, done. Finalizing the setup. Okay, great. So let's do one thing. Let's use the ExpoGo app. I'm using an Android phone, and let's scan the QR code. Okay. Okay. So we've just scanned it. New update, bundling 82%. Okay. So it's completed. In the meantime, we'll close this and let's go to responsive. And this is what it looks. Oh, nice. Okay, I'm going to sign up. Okay, so we are in. Okay, and in the app, I'm just going to paste this text and convert. Click on convert. And we have the original text here, and we have the American phonetic. And this is in my Android phone that you're seeing. So this has actually really worked out very, very well. So you have the convert. And the, let's move it around. Okay. We have the convert and the samples here, which is the placeholder text and the phonetic conversions. Let's go back to convert. There are no icons shown here, but the app actually works now. So let's do one thing. Let's go back and so let's give this follow-up prompt. In the app, show me account details and option to sign out. Okay. All right. All right. Okay, so we have it here. I'm going to sign in again. All right, we are inside. Now we have the account. Click on that and we can sign out. Okay, perfect. So that was a very simple process in building a simple app. And now if you want to deploy this app, we can click on deploy button here. Click on that. You can select deploy to web, or if you want to go to App Store, deploy to App Store, and you can go ahead from there. Okay, so this was a very simple app that we built using Bolt.new, and it was a pretty simple process. So I just wanted to show the new feature that Bolt.new has added, and I think it works really, really well, even though this was a very, very simple app, but it did the job really, really well. So that's it for this video. If you'd like to watch more videos like this, please subscribe to the channel, like this video, share it with your friends, and I'll see you in the next one.